Hello, my dear students. Welcome you all to the computer graphics lecture. In our previous lecture, we have learned about the fractals. That means how to create irregular shaped curves using some simple curves, right? So today in this video, we will learn about one such example. This curve is known as Koch curve or the Koch snowflake curve or the triadic curve. If you can see this image, the final product, it looks like a snowflake. So it is known as the snowflake curve. This is one of the earliest fractal curves to have been described. The mathematics behind this Koch curve that was first appeared in a paper titled "On a Continuous Curve Without Tangents Constructible from Elementary Geometry" by the Swedish mathematician H.V. Koch. And it was in the year of 1904, more than 100 years back. So here we start with a regular triangle and then we perform some operations and finally we will get a shape like a snowflake. As you can understand that these portions, we are continuously increasing the perimeter. Right. So the progression for the snowflake's perimeter that diverges to almost infinity, while the progression for the area of the snowflake, the area bounded by the snowflake, that converges to 8/5 times the area of the original triangle. So we can say basically the snowflake, it has a finite area bounded by an infinitely long perimeter. So Koch curve, that is self-similar. What is that? If I zoom in on any portion like this, so if n is large enough, we will understand that the shape is still the same. So we are picking up this portion. If we zoom that in, we will get this shape, which is having the same shape. Again, if we pick this portion, we will see this is the same shape. On a computer, what is the smallest line segment which we can understand? That is greater than the pixel spacing. Okay. So how to draw this curve? Initially, we will start with a straight line. Okay. Like this. Okay. Then we divide this line into three equal parts or four points. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we are dividing this straight line into three equal parts. Then we pick up the weak parts. We replace these segment by two segments. So we will assume we are having one triangle over here, equilateral triangle. So we will add two more sides of this triangle of having this 1/3 size of the original line. Okay, so I got a shape like this. And this is the first iteration, first approximation. Okay, then we will repeat this process. Now this K1 curve, this is having four segments, right? So each of these four segments, we will do the same thing. We will divide this part into three different segments, 1, 2, and 3. And then we will pick up the mid segment. These will be adjusted so that they form adjacent sides of an equilateral triangle like this. Okay. So this is the second approximation or the K2. Similarly, I am dividing this segment as well. I am dividing this segment as well. And I am dividing this segment as well. In the third iteration, what will happen? I will pick this portion. And I will divide it into three parts. Again, do the equilateral triangle forming in the mid part. I will again pick up this portion. I will divide it into three parts. I will take the mid part and replace it with the bump of two sides of equilateral triangle. So like that, this will continue infinite times or as long as you want. Okay. So the resultant curve, that is known as triadic Koch curve as well. Why? because the name is derived from the fact that the middle third of the line segments are modified at each step. If I divide the segment into that straight line into three segments, the mid part is taken and that is replaced by the equilateral triangle. So this curve is known as the triadic chords curve as well. The length of the resultant curve, that is the 4/3 times of the original length, right? So suppose this length is 1 and I am dividing it into 3 different parts, right? So the length of each part is 1/3. Now I am replacing this part with two segments, two straight lines, right? Each having the length of 1/3. So the total length is 4/3, 4 × 1/3. So 4/3, right? Now here we are having four segments and each are having the length of 4/3. So the total length is 16/9, right? 16/9 times after the second iteration. Now if I divide once again, what will be the next length? 16 × 4/9 × 3, that means 64/27, like that. So this is the original triangle. Then I am replacing it with this one. Then I am replacing it with this one. Then I am replacing it with this one. Then this one. Then this one. Like that. Okay. So let us discuss about some observations which we made from this snowflake formation. Each repetition, it increases the length of the curve by the factor 4/3. If the original length is of L, then the after first approximation, the length will be L × 4/3. In next iteration, it will be 16/9. In next iteration, it will be 64/27, like that. And the length of the curve, that is practically infinite. So more the iteration, more will be the length, right? And unlike Hilbert's curve, this curve does not fill an area. It is only modifying the parameter, nothing else, right? It does not deviate much from its original shape. So originally we had the triangle shape, and in the first, after the first iteration, we got a star shape. So eventually it will be like a star shape only. Only instead of sharp corners, we will be having molded corners, right? If we reduce the scale of the curve by 3, then we will find the curve that looks like the one, right? But we must assemble 4 such curves, right? 4 such segments to make the original one. So we can say 4 = 3^2, or D equals to log of 4/3. So these will approximately come to 1.2618. So the fractal dimension is 1.2618, while the topological dimension is 1. Fine. So how to construct it geometrically? If I want to do it programmatically or by hand, I will have a triangle like this. I will divide each side of the triangle into 3 equal parts. Then we have to draw an equilateral triangle on each middle part like this, and then we have to remove this edge, right? So again, we have to measure the length of this part. We have to divide it into 3 equal parts like this, create an equilateral triangle over here like this or like this. So this procedure will continue how long you want. Still you feel that it's not like, it's still not like a snowflake, you can continue. And eventually the perimeter would move towards infinity. Okay, so that is all about the Koch curve. If you go through the SPPU old question papers, then mostly it's like questions coming like, write a short note on Koch curve or like that. Though it is a new syllabus, we are not sure about the questions. But I think you got the basic idea. You can answer the questions. Okay. So that is all about the fifth unit. In next video, we will start with the sixth unit. Okay, you have to solve the inquiries for the attendance. Thank you.